We are, as many of you know, which I have to admit really surprised me.
Malden.
Who said Malden? Fascinating. And one of our speakers, Lynn Johnson, writes a little bit about the transformation of Malden, and perhaps we can speculate a little bit about a really interesting convergence of immigrants coming into neighborhoods that are also being rediscovered that by people that look a little bit like me, or probably more appropriately like Tim, younger urban professionals. And so the question of what the demographics of Boston, both the city and the region, are going to look like, and what that transformation, how that transformation will occur, as both Alejandra Sanguian and Lynn Johnson, our speakers, two of our speakers tonight, I'm sure will discuss this, and as many of you know, the transformation did not always come with just sort of songs and roses. There were some really difficult and at times very challenging incidents. What we can learn from that past as we look to the future, I think, is the question tonight. To explore this question, we have three speakers, as seems to be now the pattern. Tim Reardon is the director of data services for the Metropolitan Area Planning Council, which is our regional planning agency. Probably more than anyone, knows where we've come from and has among the best guesses as to where we're going. So Tim's going to take about 20 minutes to talk about what's happened and where we think we're going, including, you know, some of the open questions. As I always thought Yogi Berra said, but apparently it's an old Scandinavian proverb, it is very difficult to make predictions, particularly about the future. Yogi Berra should have said that, even if he didn't. And then we will have a panel discussion with Tim, Alejandra Sanguian, who is the director of the Mayor's Office of New Bostonians and formerly the head of OESTE. Did I pronounce that correctly? OESTE. One of the leading groups advocating for Latinos, particularly in the political system, and the emergence of immigrant groups and other non-Bostonians in the political scene in Boston is, of course, I think, part of the important story here. And then Lynn Johnson, a professor of history at Boston College, I keep tripping on that, who has written a terrific book, new book on Boston's, on the immigrants in Boston post-1965. It's the first book about Boston to come out that's not about white Irish gangsters in ages. and it's really, as somebody says in the blurb on the back, we've been waiting for somebody to really document this incredibly dramatic change and the institutional and political changes that have both spurred it and been spurred by it. We'll run our usual gamut. We'll have a panel discussion around a little bit after 7. We will pivot from a discussion among ourselves to discussion and Q&A with you. And as always, we will break as close to 8 o'clock as we can. I'll apologize in advance for Alejandra Sanguian, who has to get back to City Hall immediately. So she's not being rude if she runs by you. But tonight is the annual homelessness count. I'm
Thank you. And Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.